Hello, welcome back. Today we're going to have an application of differentiation by using certain properties of the functions. In fact, in particular, it's being even or odd for a function. And this is something that we practiced in precalculus. I'm going to explain what even or odd means again. But what we want to do today is that we want to find the values of certain integrals without using the fundamental theorem of calculus. So we don't want to find the antiderivative of this and then using the bracket notation for the upper lower limits, and then that takes you all the way to the value of the integral. This is the theorem about the integration of even and odd functions, but again, to remind you what even function means is that it should satisfy f of x equals f of negative x, and we know these functions that they are symmetric about y-axis. So let me just write it here. So you have the symmetry of the graph about y-axis. And if you have an odd function that satisfies f of x equals negative f of negative x, then you have the symmetry about the origin. Okay. So this theorem says that if you start with an even function on a very symmetric interval, negative a and a, and if you integrate the function over that interval, as you see, that the value of the integral in the even function case, it's going to be twice of the integral from 0 to a. So you don't need to have your integration from minus a to a, since the graph is symmetric about y-axis. So just find the portion that corresponds to the interval 0 and a and multiply it by 2. So that means that if you have, in fact, a symmetry about y-axis, so since you have the symmetry of y-axis, just imagine like y-axis is the mirror, and then the area on the right-hand side is reflected all the way through the y-axis. So you basically find the area from 0 to a between f and the x-axis, especially f is positive, and then twice of that is in fact the total area from minus a to a. And unfortunately, in the case of an odd function, the graph is symmetric across the origin. So you have a positive area here, let's say, and then the symmetry of that across the origin is going to be a negative area, or vice versa. You may start with a negative area, and across the y-axis, you have a positive area, exactly the same, but the positive area. So once you add them up, in other words, once you integrate the function from minus a to a, so negative area cancels the positive area, that takes you all the way to 0. So the catch here is that to know if your function is even or odd is very helpful in terms of the reducing the number of calculations. If you know that even odd function, you don't need to use the fundamental theorem of calculus. You can just conclude that the integral is equal to 0 on a symmetric interval, as you see, minus a and a. And if it's even, you can just do the calculation from 0 to a, and boom, multiply it by 2. That's, in fact, the integral of f from minus a to a. So let's look at the question statement again with this in our mind. Okay, so the given function apparently is x squared. So what can we say about evenness or oddness of f of x equals x squared? Let's start with that. So first of all, we're going to check these two properties. So let's check. What is f of minus x, in fact? So f of minus x is minus x quantity squared. Quantity squared, okay, and that is equal to x squared. So it turns out that f of x is in fact exactly equal to f of minus x. So we can go ahead and say that f is an even function, and we do have a symmetry about y-axis. So the good news is that we know the value of the integral from 0 to 3. And now part A is asking about the integral from negative 3 to 3 of x squared dx. And negative 3 and 3 is a symmetric interval. And we can go ahead and conclude that this is equal to twice of the integral from 0 to 3 of x squared dx. But since this is equal to the integral from 0 to 3, x squared dx equal to 9 by the question, so this is equal to 18. So this is the conclusion of the part A. That integral is just twice of the given value 9 that corresponds to the integral from 0 to 3. And we're using the evenness of the function to conclude that this integral is in fact twice of the area between the function x squared and the x-axis. That's 9 times 2. And how about part B? Part B has the limits negative 3 and 0. So essentially, that should be exactly equal to, by using the evenness, that should be exactly equal to, let me just write it here, integral from 0 to 3 f of x dx because of the symmetry, right? But since this is given as 9, there you go. So this integral is going to be just 9. And the last two doesn't really use evenness or oddness properties rather than just using the properties of integrals. As you see that this integral is equal to negative 6 times the integral from 0 to 3 of x squared dx. But since this is given as 9 in the problem, it's going to be negative 54. And part D is done the same way. So essentially, this is equal to 5 times the integral of f from 0 to 3, integral of x squared, but that's 9. 9 times 5 is 45. So in this particular case, we utilized the evenness of the function to find these integrals here, especially for part A and B, and part C and D, we just use the properties of general integration that if you have a constant multiple in front of a function, then you can always pull that out and then write the integral in terms of something without the constant multiple term. So in other words, I wrote this integral in C, for example, as negative 6 times just the integral of x squared from the same limits. And since it's 9, so that turned out to be negative 54. All right, this ends the video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in another video. Bye.